Soldados da Revolução asterisco 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 antero de quental Soldados da Revolução Barcelos Tipografia da Aurora do Cavado Editor RV 1896 Tiragem apenas de 100 exemplares, 20 em papel de linho. 80 em papel de algodão. N graus underscore 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 5 em 1889 publicou o César Fernando Leal, o eminente poeta dos reflexos e penumbras e dos ralâmpagos, dos primores da nossa literatura, Os Soldados da Revolução de Michelet, obra preciosa do seis grande escritor francês, precedendo a de um prólogo superiormente bem pensado e bem escrito, página brilhantíssima que para Fernando Leal não desmerece coisa alguma dos poderosos e cintilantes versos por ele firmados. Sobre esse livro, e agradecendo ao autor o oferecimento de um exemplar, escreveu-lhe antero do quental a carta que para este opúsculo trasladamos do N grau 79, segundo ano, do 1 de dezembro de 1889, da Revista Popular de Conhecimentos UTES. Antecedeu a Arre o ilustrado redactor da revista com as seguintes palavras que gostosamente reproduzimos, acerca do prefácio do Tradactar, folgamos de poder, em vez da nossa obscura apreciação, oferecer aos leitores da revista um valioso documento inédito, que representa uma levantada e autorizadíssima crítica do aludido trabalho, feita por um dos nossos maiores pensadores e escritores. É uma carta escrita por antero do quental a Fernando Leal. Os escritos do grande poeta das sete oldes modernas e do livro dos sanetos, do eminente publicista das causas da decadência dos povos Punino Salars, além do seu alto valor intrínseco, tima realçar-lhes a valia estimativa o facto de serem infelizmente cada vez mais raros. É, se a raridade é um dos predicados que tornam precioso o mais precioso dos minerais, os escritos de antero não possuem menos os outros predicados que realçam o diamante, a rijeza e o esplendor da forma em perfeita harmonia com a ideia. No inédito que publicamos, conquanto seja uma simples carta particular, e por isso mesmo, admiram-se mais uma vez aquelas altas qualidades de um espírito propenso à crítica superior dos factos e à síntese filosófica que deles deriva. É, na verdade, antero do quental é de todos os escritores portugueses, se não o único, sem dúvida aquele a quem melhor cabe o nome Augusto de filósofo, embora N. um recente escrito L.H.O. tenha negado, com audácia e a irreflexão naturas em verdes enos, um moço crítico oito aliás de grande talento, o César Guilherme Moniz Barreto. Rodrigo Veloso 9 Soldados da Revolução Vila do Conde, 8 de fevereiro Meu caro amigo obrigado pelo prazer que me deu com o seu prólogo aos Soldados da Revolução. É excelente, pensado desse sentido e escrito. O Fernando é dos poucos que ainda sabem escrever em português. E quem sabe escrever e tem que dizer não deve estar calado. Escreva, pois, que isso há de fazer-lhe bem. O Fernando precisa distrair-se, mas, para um homem do seu sentir, as distrações que servem aos outros não lhe podem servir. Só o pode distrair o trabalho, esse grande narcótico, esse dictame, dom dos deuses, sem o qual a vida dos homens que pensam intensamente seria intolerável. Escreva, pois como quise, sobre o que quise, prosa ou verso, que já dê aqui lhe asseguro que nunca lhe há de sair cousa só menos. A conclusão do seu prólogo é a de um moralista, e a única que, no meio do naufrágio de tantas esperanças, abrigará ainda as consciências sãs, faz-se que doit, adviene que porra. Mas não se entristeça demais com o que vê. A burguesia deu o 11 que podia dar, não se lhe pode exigir mais. Uma classe nunca pode ser um apóstolo, é simplesmente um elemento, uma força, cujo acto é determinado pela energia inicial. O que dará a democracia? Quem poderá dizê-lo? É o escópulo onde até hoje tinham naufragado todas as sociedades. Será que a sociedade, enquanto dividida em classes, que reagem umas sobre as outras e mutuamente se estimulam, e enquanto essas classes tinham, como tês, um fim a cumprir, uma aspiração, um ideal, será, digo, que a sociedade, em essas condições, constitua um meio mais próprio para a produção do civismo e para a têmpera dos caracteres. E que, realizadas aquelas ideias, cessando aquele estímulo, o homem, que aquela luta levantara como que acima de si mesmo, tenha fatalmente de cair na condição primitiva, na do animal de que descende doze só preocupado com materialidades e visionices. Não sei, mas o que é certo é que não há sociedade, por decadente e inferior, onde a virtude não seja possível, e, se a virtude é o fim último da vida, por conseguinte da sociedade, que não é mais que uma condição para que ela possa dar-se, direi que não há sociedade completamente perdida, completamente inútil, visto que o fim supremo nunca deixa de se realizar. A nós, espiritualistas e estoicos, deve bastar-nos isso. Sejamos nós os que perante o universo justificam a sociedade em que vivem, por podre que ela seja. Cumpra-se por nós o fim da humanidade, impulso primário de todas as sociedades, e aquela em que vivemos não terá sido, perante o ser, inútil nem estéril. E mãos à obra. Do bem, ainda o mais invisível, não se perde uma partícula, nunca se poderá perder, através do infinito 13 do tempo, através do monstruoso rodopiar das formas e dos acassos. Guarda-se e acumula-se, não sabemos como, na espiritualização permanente do universo. É um momento na grande obra do ser infinito, uma linha, uma pedra, uma areia, na estrutura do seu grande edifício, e, pequeno ou grande, lá ficará eternamente. Mãos à obra, pois, amigo, e nada de desanimar. Faça o que puder, que Deus não lhe exige mais, fazendo-o de boa vontade e de todo o coração. Ele ter-lhe ao pouco que fizerem tanta conta como o muito dos que podem mais. Comece por tratar seriamente da sua soda, considerando isso um dever, visto que é condição para o cumprimento dos outros. Depois verá. Entretanto, tome isso a sério e distraia-se escrevendo, que, por todos os lados, não será tempo perdido. 14 Quanto à Associação Editora dos Literatos, acho que é um pensamento simpático, mas um dos mais irrealizáveis. O que propõe é afinal uma cooperativa de produção. Ora, este gênero de associação, pela sua mesma superioridade, exige condições nos trabalhadores associados que ainda hoje se não dão em classe alguma. Todas as cooperativas de produção tinham fracassado desastrosamente, e é por isso, entre parênteses, que o capitalismo próspera, porque não há ainda quem o substitua, ainda entre as classes trabalhadoras dotadas de mais senso prático e moral e espírito de disciplina. Mas de todos os trabalhadores, o literário é justamente aquele a quem mais faltam aqueles diversos sensos. Os calafates, ou fereros, ou trapeiros valem, em este ponto de vista, infinitamente mais que os melhores literatos. Considerar isto é considerar como 15 chimérica qualquer tentativa no sentido do seu artigo. E adeus. Do seu do coração antero de quental fim. Asterisco, asterisco, asterisco em Joff de Project Gutenberg e Ebook Soldados da Revolução, asterisco, asterisco, asterisco update de editions will replace the previous one the old editions will be renamed. Creating the works from print editions not protected by U.S. copyright law minus that no one owns a United States copyright in these works, so the foundation, and you, can copy and distribute it in the United States without permission and without paying copyright royalties. Special rules. Set forth in the general terms of use part of this license, apply to copying and distributing Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works to protect the Project Gutenberg trademark concept and trademark. Project Gutenberg is a registered trademark, and may not be used if you charge for an e-book, except by following the terms of the trademark license, including paying royalties for use of the Project Gutenberg trademark. If you do not charge anything for copies of this e-book, complying with the trademark license is very easy. You may use this e-book for nearly any purpose such as creation of derivative works, reports, performances and research. Project Gutenberg e-books may be modified and printed and given away. You may do practically anything in the United States with e-books not protected by U.S. copyright law. Redistribution is subject to the trademark license, especially commercial redistribution. Start, full license the full Project Gutenberg license please read before you distribute or use this work to protect the Project Gutenberg trademark mission of promoting the free distribution of electronic works. By use or distributing this work, or any other work associated in any way with the phrase Project Gutenberg, you agree to comply with all the terms of the full Project Gutenberg trademark license available with this file or online at www.gutenberg.org/license. Section 1. General Terms of Use and Redistributing Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works 1. By reading or use any part of this Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Work, you indicate that you have read, understand, agree to and accept all the terms of this license and intellectual property, Trademark barra copyright, agreement. If you do not agree to abide by all the terms of this agreement, you must cease use and return or destroy all copies of Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works in your possession. If you pay the fee for obtaining a copy of your access to a project Gutenberg trademark electronic work and you do not agree to be bound by the terms of this agreement, you may obtain a refund from the person or entity to whom you paid the fee as set forth in paragraph 1.E8. 1.B Project Gutenberg is a registered trademark. It may only be used on or associated in any way with an electronic work by people who agree to be bound by the terms of this agreement. There are a few fees that you can do with most Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works even without complying with the full terms of this agreement. See paragraph 1.C below. There are a lot of fees you can do with Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works if you follow the terms of this agreement and help preserve free future access to Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works. See paragraph 1.E below. 1c. The Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the Foundation ORPGLAF, owns a compilation copyright in the collection of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works. Nearly all the individual works in the collection are in the public domain in the United States. If individual works are not protected by copyright law in the United States and you are located in the United States, we do not claim a right to prevent you from copying, distributing, performing, displaying or creating derivative works based on the work as long as all references to Project Gutenberg are removed. Of course, we hope that you will support the Project Gutenberg trademark mission of promoting free access to electronic works by freely sharing Project Gutenberg trademark works in compliance with the terms of this agreement for keep the Project Gutenberg trademark name associated with the work. You can easily comply with the terms of this agreement by keep this work in the same format with its attached full Project Gutenberg trademark license when you share it without charge with others. 1.D. The copyright laws of the place where you are located also govern what you can do with this work. Copyright laws in most countries are in a constant state of change. If you are outside the United States, check the laws of your country in addition to the terms of this agreement before downloading, copying, displaying, performing, distributing or creating derivative works based on this work or any other Project Gutenberg trademark work. The Foundation makes no representations concerning the copyright status of any work in any country other than the United States. 1.E unless you have removed all references to Project Gutenberg, 1.E1. The following sentence, with active links to, or other immediate access to, the full Project Gutenberg trademark license must appear permanently whenever any copy of a Project Gutenberg trademark work, any work on which the phrase Project Gutenberg appears, or with which the phrase Project Gutenberg is associated, is accessed, displayed, performed, viewed, copied or distributed, this e-book is for the use of anyone anywhere in the United States and most other parts of the world at no cost and with almost no restrictions whatsoever. You may copy it, Give it away or reuse it under the terms of the Project Gutenberg license included with this ebook or online at www.gutenberg.org. If you are not located in the United States, you will have to check the laws of the country where you are located before using this ebook. 1.E2. IF Individual Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works Derived from Texts Not Protected by U.S. Copyright Law, Does Not Contain a Notice in the Caption That It Is Posted With Permission of the Copyright Holder, The Work Can Be Copied and Distributed to Anyone in the United States Without Paying Any Fees or Charges. If you are redistributing or providing access to a work with the phrase Project Gutenberg associated with or appearing on the work, you must comply either with the requirements of paragraphs 1.E1 through 1.E7 or obtain permission for the use of the work and the Project Gutenberg trademark asset forth in paragraphs 1.E8 or 1.E9. 1.E3. IF Individual Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works Posted With The Permission Of The Copyright Holder, Your Use And Distribution Must Comply With Both Paragraphs 1.E1 through 1.E7 And Any Additional Terms Imposed By The Copyright Holder. Additional terms will be linked to the Project Gutenberg trademark license for all works posted with the permission of the copyright holder found at the beginning of this work. 1.E4. Do not unlink or detach or remove the full Project Gutenberg trademark license terms from this work. Or any files containing a part of this work or any other work associated with Project Gutenberg trademark. 1.E5. Do not copy, display, perform, distribute or redistribute this electronic work, or any part of this electronic work, without permanently displaying the sentence set forth in paragraph 1.E1 with active links or immediate access to the full terms of the Project Gutenberg trademark license. 1.E6. You may convert to and distribute this work in any binary, compressed, marked up, non-proprietary or proprietary form, including any word processing or hypertext form, however, if you provide access to or distribute copies of a Project Gutenberg trademark work in a format other than plain vanilla ASCII or other format used in the official version posted on the official Project Gutenberg trademark website, www.gutenberg.org fecha parênteses you must, at no additional cost, fee or expense to the user, provide a copy, a means of exporting a copy, or a means of obtaining a copy upon request, of the work in its original plain vanilla ASCII or other form any alternate format must include the full Project Gutenberg trademark license as specified in paragraph 1.E1. 1.E7. Do not charge a fee for access to, viewing, displaying, performing, copying or distributing any Project Gutenberg trademark works unless you comply with paragraph 1.E8 or 1.E9. 1.E8. You may charge Arizona Blue Fee for caps of your providing access to or distributing Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works provided that. Item you pay a royalty fee of 20% of the gross profits you derive from the use of Project Gutenberg trademark works calculated using the method you already use to calculate your applicable taxes. The fees owed to the owner of the Project Gutenberg trademark. But he has agreed to donate royalties under this paragraph to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. Royalty payments must be paid within 60 days following each date on which you prepare, or are legally required to prepare, your periodic tax returns. Royalty payments should be clearly marked as such and sent to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation at the address specified in Section 4, Information about Donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. Item you provide a full refund of any money paid by a user who notifies you in writing, or by e-mail, within 30 days of receipt that S/he does not agree to the terms of the full Project Gutenberg trademark license. You must require such a user to return or destroy all copies of the works possessed in a physical media and discontinue all use of and all access to other copies of Project Gutenberg trademark works. Item you provide, in accordance with paragraph 1.f3, a full refund of any money paid for a work or a replacement copy, if a defect in the electronic works discovered and reported to you within 90 days of receipt of the work. Item you comply with all other terms of this agreement for free distribution of Project Gutenberg trademark works. 1.E9. If you wish to charge a fee or distribute a Project Gutenberg trademark electronic work or group of works on different terms than are set forth in this agreement, you must obtain permission in writing from the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the manager of the Project Gutenberg trademark. Contact the Foundation as set forth in Section 3 below. 1.F1.F1. Project Gutenberg volunteers and employees que spend considerable effort to identify, do copyright research on, transcribe and proofread works not protected by U.S. copyright law in creating the Project Gutenberg trademark collection. Despite these efforts, Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works, and the media on which they may be stored, may contain defects such as, but not limited to, incomplete, inaccurate or corrupt data, transcription errors, a copyright or other intellectual property infringement, a defective or damaged disk or other media, a computer virus, or computer codes that damage or cannot be read by your equipment. 1.F2. Limited warranty, disclaimer of damages, except for the right of replacement or refund described in paragraph 1.F3, the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, the owner of the Project Gutenberg trademark, and any other party distributing a Project Gutenberg trademark electronic work under this agreement, disclaim all liability theory for damages, costs and expenses, including legal fees. You agree that you have no remedies for negligence, strict liability, breach of warrant or breach of contract except as provided in paragraph 1.f3. You agree that the foundation, the trademark owner, and any distributor under this agreement will not be liable to you for actual, direct, indirect, consequential, punitive or incidental damages even if you give notice of the possibility of such damage. 1.f3. Limited right of replacement or refund. If you discover a defect in this electronic work within 90 days of receiving it, you can receive a refund of the money, if any, you paid for it by sending a written explanation to the person you received the work from. If you received the work on a physical medium, you must return the medium with your written explanation. The person or entity that provided you with the defective work may elect to provide a replacement cap in lieu of a refund. If you received the work electronically, the person or entity providing it to you may choose to give you a second opportunity to receive the work electronically in lieu of a refund. If the second cap is also defective, you may demand a refund in writing without further opportunities to fix the problem. 1.f4. Except for the limited right of replacement or refund set forth in paragraph 1.f3, this work is provided to you as is, with no other warranties of any kind, express or implied, including but not limited to warranties of merchantability or fitness for any purpose. 1.f5. Some states do not allow disclaimers of certain implied warranties or the exclusion or limitation of certain types of damages. If any disclaimer or limitation set forth in this agreement violates the law of the state applicable to the agreement shall be interpreted to make the maximum disclaimer or limitation permitted by the applicable state law. The invalidity or unenforceability of any provision of this agreement shall not void the remaining provisions. 1.f6. Indemnity, you agree to indemnify and hold the foundation, the trademark owner, any agent or employee of the foundation, anyone providing copies of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works in accordance with this agreement, and any volunteers associated with the production, promotion and distribution of Project Gutenberg trademark electronic works, harmless from all liability, costs and expenses, including legal fees, that arise directly or indirectly from any of the following which would or cause to occur. A. Distribution of this or any Project Gutenberg trademark work. B. Alteration, modification, or additions or deletions to any Project Gutenberg trademark work. And C. Any defect you cause. Section 2. Information about the mission of Project Gutenberg trademark. Project Gutenberg trademark is synonymous with the free distribution of electronic works in formats readable by the widest variety of computers, including obsolete, old, mid-aged and new computers. It exists because of the efforts of hundreds of volunteers and donations from people in all walks of life. Volunteers and financial support to provide volunteers with the assistance they need are critical to reach Project Gutenberg trademark goals and ensuring that the Project Gutenberg trademark collection will remain freely available for generations to come. Em 2001, The Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation was created to provide a secure and permanent future for Project Gutenberg trademark and future generations. To learn more about the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation and how your efforts and donations can help, see Sections 3 and 4 and the Foundation Information Page at www.gutenberg.org. Section 3. Information about the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. The Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation is a non-profit 501(c)(3). Educational Corporation organized under the laws of the State of Mississippi and granted tax-exempt status by the Internal Revenue Service. The Foundation's Senior Federal Tax Identification Number is 64-6221541. Contributions to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation are tax deductible to the full extent permitted by U.S. federal laws and your state's laws. The Foundation's business office is located at 809 North 1500 West, Salt Lake City, Utah 84116. 801596188 E-mail contact links and up-to-date contact information can be found at the Foundation's website and official page at www.gutenberg.org/contact-section-4. Information about donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation. Project Gutenberg trademark depends upon and cannot survive without widespread public support and donations to carry outubro its mission of increasing the number of public domain and license to works that can be freely distributed in machine readable form accessible by the widest array of equipment including outdated equipment. Many small donations, $1 to cifrão 5,000, are particularly important to maintaining tax-exempt status with the IRS. The Foundation is committed to complying with the laws regulating charities and charitable donations in all 50 states of the United States. Compliance requirements are not uniform and it takes a considerable effort, much paperwork and many fees to meet and keep up with these requirements. We do not solicit donations in locations where we have not received written confirmation of compliance. To send donations or determine the status of compliance for any particular state, visit www.gutenberg.org/donate. While we cannot and do not solicit contributions from states where we have not met the solicitation requirements, we know of no prohibition against accepting unsolicited donations from donors in such states who approach us with offers to donate. International donations are gratefully accepted, But we cannot make any statements concerning tax treatment of donations received from outside the United States. U.S. laws alone empower small staff. Please check the Project Gutenberg web pages for current donation methods and addresses. Donations are accepted in a number of other ways, including checks, online payments and credit card donations. To donate, please visit www.gutenberg.org/donate. Section 5. General Information about Project Gutenberg Trademark Electronic Works. Professor Michael S. Hart was the originator of the Project Gutenberg Trademark concept of a library of electronic works that could be freely shared with anyone. For 40 years, reproduced and distributed Project Gutenberg trademark ebooks with only a loose network of volunteer support. Project Gutenberg trademark ebooks are often created from several printed editions, all of which are confirmed as not protected by copyright in the US unless a copyright notice is included. Thus, we do not necessarily keep ebooks in compliance with any particular paper edition. Most people start at our website, which has the MyMPG Cert Facility, www.gutenberg.org. This website includes information about Project Gutenberg trademark, including how to make donations to the Project Gutenberg Literary Archive Foundation, how to help produce our new ebooks, and how to subscribe to our email newsletter to hear about new ebooks. Soldados da Revolução Fim de Full Project Gutenberg License.